टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट सेपरेटिंग एंड थ्रोटलिंग कैलोरी मीटर। फर्स्टली वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट कैलोरी मीटर। व्हाट इज कैलोरी मीटर? वी नो दैट कैलोरी मीटर इज एन ऑब्जेक्ट फॉर मेजरिंग द हीट कैपेसिटी ऑफ द केमिकल रिएक्शन। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट सेपरेटिंग एंड थ्रोटलिंग कैलोरी मीटर। दिस इज द कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ टू कैलोरी मीटर, सेपरेटिंग एंड थ्रोटलिंग कैलोरी मीटर। We have separating calorimeter. As we discussed earlier lecture, this is the figure of the separating calorimeter. And on the right hand side, we have throttling calorimeter. These both are engaged with the help of pipe. And this pipe has a orifice or throttle valve with a pressure gauge. This is a thermometer with oil. So this is the combination of separating and throttling calorimeter. Now we see the working of both the calorimeter. When steam will come from the sampling tube, it will enter in the separating calorimeter inner chamber, where it will strike to the separator, and by the strike effect some water will be collected in the inner chamber of the separating calorimeter, and this water we can shown in the water level indicator. Then after this, dry steam will be escape out and it will go towards the pipe, and pipe will transfer this superheated steam to the throttling calorimeter. There it will pass through the orifice or throttle valve. Then after this, it will go to the inner chamber of the throttling calorimeter, where it will passes from the inner to outer chamber, and then in the steam condensing chamber. We can note temperature of the superheated steam after throttling in the throttling calorimeter, and we can measure pressure before throttling. So this is the working of separating and throttling calorimeter. Some points are note before sampling and after sampling are: before sampling we have to note pressure of wet steam before throttling and temperature of wet steam before throttling. Then after sampling, mass of water in inner chamber of the separating calorimeter will be measured. It is denoted by small m. And mass of steam condensed in steam condenser chamber is denoted by capital mass M in the throttling calorimeter. And pressure of superheated steam and temperature of superheated steam will also measure after sampling. Then what will be the dryness fraction? Capital X will be equal to X1 into X2, means dryness fraction of the separating calorimeter into dryness fraction of the throttling calorimeter. So we can calculate the dryness fraction of the steam by the combination of separating and throttling calorimeter. Thank you for seeing this video. For more updated videos, you can subscribe me on my channel, Learn and Grow. Thank you.